Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
Today we have a topic with us, it's called mark-to-market accounting. M2M is a very normal or a common thing in financial stock market. So first, what is the M2M marketing or M2M accounting? Okay, fine. See, M2M accounting is very simple concept, which means, you know, recording the value of the given asset at the current market value instead of the historical buying price. So M2M accounting means, you know, recording the value of the balance sheet assets and liabilities at the current market value. Okay, with the aim to provide a fair appraisal of the company's financials. Now, let's discuss the M2M, that is mark to marketing accounting versus historical accounting. Now, see, accounting data is historical in nature. Accounting data is historical nature. So if an asset is purchased, the cost which is paid to acquire the asset along with all the realized cost for bringing the asset to its location in the required state can also be added to the purchase cost. So these cost is then, you know, depreciated. These costs are basically depreciated year on year basis. And the net value is reflected in the balance sheet of the company. So these value is independent of the market value. So the market value can be, it can be higher, okay, than the, than or equal, it can be higher or equal to the same or even lower than the net depreciated value recorded in the books of accounts. So accounting does not consider the mark to market value. Then the recorded is carried out at the historical because of one of the basic accounting principle of prudence. Now, as for the principle of accounting, are expected to accountants to be cautious while recognizing the gains. Now, if we tend to value our assets to the M2M, we will recognize the unrealized gains in the books. Further, there is no specific basis for arriving at the market value in the most of the cases. So the booking the assets at the book value might end up giving up very unrealistic picture to user of the financial statement. So these are certain exception to the above rule of reflecting assets at the historical value on the face of the balance sheet. Now, as per the accounting standard, there are certain assets which are specifically shown at the market value at the end of the accounting period. And these rules are more specifically designed for the financial instrument rather than the physical long-term assets like land, building, computer, and so on and so forth. So the reason for marketing these securities to the market value gives us a true picture, and the value is more relevant as compared to the historical value. So financial securities are generally volatile in nature, and the market value is the only true value of the securities, especially if these assets are classified as available for sale or trading. Now we will take some of the examples here to understand this. The first is available for sale securities. Now, available for sale securities is the most common example of the mark to market accounting. An available for sale asset, it is the financial security which can either be in the form of debt or equity purchased with the intent of selling the securities before it reaches to its maturity. So in cases of the security which do not have maturity, these securities will be sold prior you know, to a long time period for which, you know, these securities are generally held. So any gains or loss from fluctuation in the market value of the asset is classified as available for sale, will be reported, okay, in the other comprehensive income account in the equity section of the balance sheet. Now the second is called the held for trading example. Now another common example of mark to market accounting is a held for trading asset is a financial security, which can either be in the form of debt, which can be either be in the it can be either in the form of debt or equity, and is purchased with the intention of selling the security within a short period of time, and which is generally less than a year time span. So any gains or losses from the fluctuations in the market value of the asset classified as available for trading and will be reported as unrealized gains or losses on the income statement. Now we will do the journal entry part here. First is the available for sale securities. So in this case, the value of the asset is written down or increased as per the market value of the gains or losses are booked, and the equity shares of the value, let's say example, equity shares of the value of let's say 10,000 are purchased on 1st of September 2016. Okay, now as on 31st of December 2016, that is the close of the financial year 2016, the value of the equity is, let's say over here, $8,000. So assuming that these equity shares are available for sale, the security should be recorded at the market value, and the mark to market value journal entry will be loss on securities, loss on securities available for sale account, that is $2,000, to investment available for sale account, that is again $2,000. So in the balance sheet, the investment will be shown at a new amount of how much? 10,000 minus 2,000, that is 8,000. And the loss will be recorded in the other comprehensive income. So now assuming that, you know, the close of the next accounting year, that is 31st of December 2017 or 31st of December 2017, the market value of these equity shares is 11,000, and as compared to the previous year, the gain is of $3,000. So the market to mark to market accounting journal entry for the sale for the same will be investment available for sale, that will be 3,000, and to credit will be given to gain on securities available, that is 1,000, and to loss on securities, that is 2,000. So that's it in terms of journal entries. Now there are other also like held for trading. We have for them, you know, the different sort of accounting is done. You know, a separate accounting account is known as for held for trading case, which is the second one. Held for trading, it is known as the security fair value adjustments account, okay, which will be shown on the face of the balance sheet along with the security account is created, and any increase or decrease, okay, in the fair value is to be adjusted in this account. any fair value is to be adjusted. So the equity share value of, let's say, 10,000 are purchased on, let's say, 1st of September 2016. As on 31st December, the close of the financial year, the value of the equity shares is $12,000. So the difference of $2,000 gain is on account of the marking the securities to the market. And mark-to-market accounting journal entry of the same will be something like this. Security fair value adjustments account debit, that is $2,000 to unrealized gain or loss, that is $2,000. So that's it for this particular topic. You know, if you have any other questions, you can ask and jam in the comments.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.